Hi, I'm Stardust, and welcome back to Anole Alley for the season finale. Like the garden scene here, in its summer splendor, Anole Alley will also be going away for the winter. But don't worry, we'll be back again next year, along with Hurricane Garden and all of its tropical foliage. But now, it's early December, and this is what remains of the garden since the last bout of freezing weather. We've had record low temperatures for our area along the Gulf Coast, dipping down into the teens for several nights in a row. Don't let the winter blues get you down. Let's just all get down with the blues. And the Anoles. Shortly after those record-breaking low temperatures and those cold nights, we again rebounded and our temperatures once more broke records. This time, on the other end of the spectrum, with temperatures reaching the lower 80s for December. And the Anoles were out enjoying every moment, as was I. Like this guy, seen here, hiding very well in the dead leaves of this lantana. Lantana is a flowering shrub, and it blooms throughout the summer. It, too, will be back again next year. Actually, I counted four Anoles here, all basking and hunting peacefully in what's left of the tropical plants. These used to be those huge, beautiful caladiums, I think, or as we Southerners call them, elephant ears. Well, they may be gone, but the Anoles are still making use of their stalks. They're using those to stalk their prey. Yep, looks like the garden Anoles, as we've come to know and love them, are flourishing, showing us that they can take the abrupt changes in climate that we all face living here on the Deep South. And I'm also seeing many new hatchlings out, like this one. The definition of a hatchling is any young lizard that's less than 2 inches from snout to vent. And this guy is about that size. Obviously, the product of a late summer clutch of eggs. And I've also learned that the iguana's hutch is an Anole nursery and an oasis. It's all that and more wrapped into one package. And it was here where we first met two other hatchlings. Apollo, seen here in this footage shot just before Christmas. And another thing that I've learned about Anoles, they definitely have a sweet tooth. They love fruit. Apollo was seen out just about every other day if the temperatures got high enough in his usual haunts around the house and the iguana hutch. He's in with a group of lizards that I refer to affectionately as the house lizards. No, not the house of blues. I just call them the house lizards because they tend to hang out near or on the house. Anoles love to hang out around the windows. There are plenty of places to hide and places to hunt for flies. This area is the dog kennel, and there are more than enough flies and other pesky insects to go around. Another thing I love about the common green Anole, they are truly green. Well, maybe not in color most of the time. But green for the environment. I'm pretty sure that this little guy is Starbuck. The markings and the shape of the head all seem to match. However, young Anoles grow quickly, and it's really hard to tell them apart at times. But we all know the other house lizards, Leo and Spider. Spider and Leo have also proven themselves to be intelligent and resourceful. Spider, so named for the tropical spider plant where I first found her, looks today like she could be full of eggs or flies. And this is the famous spider plant before all that cold weather. She used to call this home. What a cool place for a nap. And finally, we became familiar with a group of Anoles that live next to the house and the chain link fence that I've dubbed the Chain Gang. Led by this handsome fellow that we've grown to know as Brownie. Brownie is a large dominant male. But I've also spotted Leo over here too. The smaller brown lizards are the females that Brownie and Leo vie over occasionally. They can all be seen out basking along the fence and the edge of the house most of the time in a peaceful congregation. Yes, there are a lot of them. I love it. Whoa, now that's what I call a buzz. And here's one of the rock stars. We've met a lot of Anoles here in the alley, and I've learned much about these small creatures, and I hope you have too. I hope I've taught you a little bit about their habits and their habitats. I feel privileged to have them around so abundantly, and that I've been able to show you guys their world. As for Leo, seen here, and Brownie, who so gallantly poses on the post, and the rest. Oh, and this is Bo, our 11-year-old American Pit Bull Terrier. So, what's become of the rest of the Anoles? Starbuck? Apollo? Well,